are standing up and speaking truth to power, because in Russia right now, there are three women sitting in a jail cell waiting to be sentenced to as much as 3 years in a hard labor camp. And why? Because they sang a political song. And we believe that these women are prisoners of conscience, and that if you put people in jail simply because they express themselves, you are unleashing a world of negativity and threat to people's freedom and human rights all around the world. So we're right outside the Russian embassy, and we're going to play some loud music, because music has always been a way for people to express their beliefs. And so today we're going to express our beliefs, and we're going to free Pussy Riot. So I want to call up some friends before we get started. We are gathered here today, and we are accompanied by the legendary CBGB. So can I get Tim and Louise up here? So for those of you who don't know, CBGB has been for 40 years this amazing symbol for punk rock folks everywhere, but also for those who understand that music is a vehicle for us to speak truth to power. And I want to thank them for all they're doing to help call attention to this, to make sure these women aren't disappeared. So everyone, Tim and Louise from CBGB, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, everybody, for coming.
All right, so you didn't come here to listen to me. I want to turn it over to one of our coalition partners, a great DC-based artist who has done enormous work to make sure that everyone understands how important this case is. Because this is about three young women whose lives are about to be taken away. It's about bigger things than that as well. The crackdown that we're seeing for every citizen in Russia if they're trying to speak their piece. There are now huge fines being levied against people just for gathering in public places. We're seeing NGOs being denied the opportunity to be out there in public and do their work. And we're seeing crackdowns on things like pride parades, and we're seeing internet being disrupted and cut off from certain websites. We can't tolerate this in Russia, and we can't tolerate this around the world. So thank you for being here, for speaking up, for standing up, and for demanding that we free Pussy Riot. And I want to welcome Andrea Collins to the stage. Thank you.
Hi. First thing up, I'm not going to take long, so I know you're here from the bands, but I want to thank everybody who worked on this, because, of course, it wouldn't be possible if they didn't, but I also want to thank everybody who's here, because you're almost more important than the people who worked on things here. No matter what we put together, if you weren't here, this would be nothing. But the second thing I want to note is kind of following on what you just said. If we were in Moscow right now, you all standing right there waiting for these speeches to end and those bands to start would be arrested, and you would pay $9,000 in fines, and that would be more than your annual salary, which would be averaging $1,500. If you couldn't pay your $9,000 fine, you would do 200 hours worth of hard labor. But if you slandered, if you said anything nasty that slandered anyone or insulted anyone, particularly a prosecutor, a judge, or a politician, you would pay $157,000 and $726 fine just for doing that. And you wouldn't even have to be at that protest to do that. And you would do 480 hours of compulsory work in a labor camp. That is, unless you got so fed up with your government that you started some protests and actions that included conveying your thoughts and feelings about maybe gender and LGBT rights, or problems of masculine conformity, or the absence of a daring political message on the musical and art scenes, or the domination of males in all areas of public discourse. These are Pussy Riot's issues. If you express this in Russia, someone would probably brand you as a hater of some kind right now. And if that were the case, if you hated and performed at the same time, who knows what would happen? Maybe janitors would lose sleep behind your hateful behavior, or you could cause another 9/11, like Pussy Riot's been accused of. In either case, you would be at risk of being sent to a corrective labor colony, like the one we just talked about, and enjoying their special hospitality for women, believe me, along with nonstop labor for a long time. Like, what could you do? You could go into a church in a vintage dress with some contrasting tights, hop up in the sanctuary, do a few high kicks, and utter shit a few times, along with some language about the separation of church and state. You'd be screwed. And who might do this? You all might do this. People just like you or me. Upcoming politically aware DC 20-somethings, or their teachers, or activists, or musicians, or maybe any caring citizen. This town's full of Pussy Riot types. Don't you think Pussy Riot would get along well in D.C.? I think they would, yeah. I think they would. Katya, for example, is a computer programmer with a degree from a cutting-edge school. Her professor said in court her final project was one of the best in the school's history. She's an overachiever, just like any D.C. 29-year-old. Masha's 24. She's a single mother. Her kid's in kindergarten. She's done volunteer work with sick kids and Greenpeace. Sound familiar to any of you? She's finishing up a journalism and creative writing program when she was arrested. These people are you. Nadia's 22. She's a longtime activist. She was in the last year of her philosophy studies at a hot school when she was arrested. Her husband is now taking care of her 4-year-old. They're like you. They're like average up-and-coming DC 20-somethings and professors and musicians and aware individuals, often activist men, which is not average at all, really, because those qualities come with a tenacious streak. They have a tenacious streak, and so do you. And if these women are convicted, I think your tenacious streak will really come out. The people here, you and me, know if Pussy Riot girls are convicted, that won't be the end of things. You will continue to make sure Masha and Nadia and Katya know we're watching. And you'll continue to watch, and you will make noise. Like the refrain from the Mobius strip song they're going to do tonight, Green is the New Red, we won't shut up. We won't back down because we don't shut up and we don't back down here in this town. A friend sent me a quote today by Joseph Ross. He's a local poet. The quote is, "I write to remember that I'm not alone here. Knowing we are all in this life together can save us." I believe that everybody here wants to make sure Nadia, Katya, and Masha know they're not alone. And we'll continue making the kind of noise we're making today until they're free. We'll continue coming up around this embassy across the street and conducting actions and protests and making people aware of Russia's new backwardness until Russia lets Pussy Riot go. Because until they're free, none of us is quite free, because we are all part of what Pussy Riot calls their pulsating and growing body, just like they are. Before we give it up for the bands that are playing tonight, I think we ought to give it up for Pussy Riot one more time. And Dave from Brenda is going to help us by reading a few chants. First, Dave.
All right. Here we are. Like I said earlier, it's important that these bands are playing tonight because Pussy Riot can't play. And any musician loves to play. That's what we like to do most of all. So we're out here supporting them. Let's see. Let's look at the Russian embassy. Let's call it out for the three girls. You repeat after me. Maria, Nadezhda, and Ekaterina. Don't lose hope. We're never gonna leave you. Maria, Nadezhda,
and Ekaterina.
Don't lose hope.
We're never gonna leave you.
Maria, Nadezhda,
and Ekaterina.
Don't lose hope.
We're never gonna leave you.
Maria, Nadezhda,
and Ekaterina.
Don't lose hope.
We're never gonna leave you.
Maria, Nadezhda,
and Ekaterina.
Don't lose hope.
We're never gonna leave you.
Freedom of expression, not repression. Freedom of expression,
not repression.
Freedom of expression,
not repression.
Freedom of expression,
not repression.
Freedom of expression,
not repression.
Maria, Nadezhda,
and Ekaterina.
Don't lose hope.
We're never gonna leave ya.
All right. Play some music.
Okay, I'm gonna quickly announce these bands. Tonight we have Sad Bones. Hot punk, right? They didn't send me a statement, so I don't have too much I can say except they're hot punk. Brenda plays jangly indie rock, like about animals, like manatees being chopped up by propellers, and about things suck at work, and about love, and they really came through with the protest last time. They were at the last protest. We couldn't play. They led everything, and they're really important to this movement. So they're political jangly rock band. Mobius Strip is a band that Washington Post Mark Jenkins described as a worthy descendant of 1980s DC hardcore. It's a group of DC based musicians active in animal rights, environmental protection, and social justice movement. War on Women, who is also playing, is melodically plays fast punk tinged garage rock with melodic overtones. They couple with a clueless jackass, get a clue, jackass type feminine lyrics. In other words, awesome feminist hardcore. Alright everyone, give it up for Sad Bone!
This song last night for Pussy Riot, and it should be loud enough we can hear it in Russia. From Brenda really quick? Okay. Anyone?
Yeah,
the guitarist?
The guitarist
specific?
We lost the string.
Oh, we lost the string.
That's how much we...
That's right.
let's get the momentum.
huge thank you to Sag Bones. That was awesome. I'm so glad that they picked us off. Next, we're going to have Brenda. As you may have known, if you were here last time, they did pledge to wear their balaclavas every single concert until Pussy Riot was released. So they'll be working extra hard up here in balaclava, so stick around and they'll be up shortly.
We're Brenda, and we're honored to be here playing in support of Pussy Riot. They've asked that we read a statement that we wrote earlier for the first protest. Sentiments are still all the same, even though it's a couple weeks later. So why is Brenda here tonight playing in support of Pussy Riot? Because we can and they can't. Like politics, music is about being authentic. Fans can spot a poser, and voters can spot a fake. If Pussy Riot's mission is to drag truth to the doorstep of the Kremlin, no one should stop them. But someone can try. That someone would be Vladimir Putin. What Putin really is a coward. Instead of engaging in public discourse with Pussy Riot, the far braver thing to do, he cowardly throws them in jail using his paid mercenaries and denies them access even to their own children. What we can do is counteract Putin and his ilk's thuggery by taking the high road, which is not violence. It's free speech. While we still have a relatively open forum in America, we owe it to Pussy Riot to exercise our liberties. And it feels good to see how far those liberties can stretch, hopefully from one side of the Atlantic across to the other. So someone has to play for Pussy Riot today, because they would do the same for us.
Thank you.
lineup. Kind of like Pussy Riot.
Just like Pussy Riot. They're a punk collective.
Hopefully you can't tell who any of us are. That one was called Manatee. That's about, like Andrew said, people cutting up manatees. We shouldn't do it. That's not cool. Just if you go boating anywhere around Miami, go slow and watch out for the manatees. All right, this one is about accepting everyone for who they are, especially because of their sexual orientation. Relationships with women have always seemed to be a disaster. Someone ho to Ohio. I wish this was, but my friends, they found an answer. Master my fears of the old agenda and put in for a transfer. My friends are so far, go on and give it a try. That's the worst that could happen to me, to fall in love with a girl. But 80% of the population don't matter what they're all enjoying. You want to stop and all of these opportunities for collaboration. Will my time she saw the next two men? Oh, will it trust me? I don't know. There's going to be things that will say, but like buying you flowers, laughing back to women whenever I want. Now this is a choice of pleasures. The only difference is I got a new stick, but with success is measured. About liking everything about yourself that other people hate.
Let it go, it's a ball of hoes. Toes are gone, the body Got a job today. Steady pay, health care, enough for 401k. But with your long feet, take to be refined. Not to make a little chair, not to crush my spine. Got a job to turn this. I'm
you a pass. Do not have to send remittances.
In 1931, the Russian government actually blew up the church that Pussy Riot protested in. The church wasn't rebuilt for another 60 years, and one of the first things the Russian government did was canonize the Romanovs. You know, the last czar. So, I think it's been used for political purposes before. I don't know if you agree with me. But I don't think any ground is sacred. Except this one. And everywhere where we're supporting each other.
No rules, Brendan!
Woo! Thank you, Joe. Number two fan. Okay, this one's called Work Week Death. It's the last one.
All right, thanks, guys.
And it's Friday. Yeah, thanks for coming.
Friday!
Thank you.
All right, everybody, give it up one more time for Brenda, all right? So while we wait for the next band to come up, Mobius Strip, I just want to talk a little bit about, again, why we're here. But before that, in case people hadn't noticed, if you feel your energy dropping, there are some food trucks over there. So give it up for food trucks, right? And so, first of all, I just want to thank all of you for coming out here. This has been a huge, huge undertaking that's much bigger than Amnesty International. I'm an organizer with Amnesty. My name is Jeeva, and so I recognize many faces here. There are some longtime Amnesty members, longtime staff members, and at the same time, there are lots and lots of people who are affiliated with lots of different organizations, individuals standing up, responding to that call that really Pussy Riot raised for us, which is to stand up for free expression and not repression. So, give it up for that, right? So, on that note, I want to remind us why we're here and why we're in this exact location. So, if you look off to your left, that's the Russian embassy. And we're here tonight so that they hear us. And not only so that they hear us, but so that Vladimir Putin in Russia hears us. Again, amplifying that call that Pussy Riot has raised. Pussy Riot is important, not just because there are three women right now, Maria, Nadezhda, and Ekaterina, who recently finished up their trial, who are awaiting their sentence, expecting to see that sentence in just a couple of weeks, and we have an opportunity to stop them from being locked up for even a single day. So, what they've done, Pussy Riot is an idea at this point, right? Pussy Riot is about culture, is about standing up, is about making sure that the call for free expression, not repression, is raised around the world, and that's exactly what's happening. So not only are individuals standing here today, but people around the country, around the world, are tweeting using the hashtag Free Pussy Riot. So if you haven't done that tonight, if you have your smartphone, get that out, talk about why you're here, raise that call, continue to raise the call for action. The other thing that I want to say really quickly before I wrap up and before Mobius Strip comes up here is that the actions that have been taken have been going on for weeks and weeks and weeks now. And so last week, or a couple weeks ago, many of the people who are here were standing across the street rallying for Pussy Riot. So let me hear you if you were here a couple weeks ago. And so, as you remember, what happened is we got asked to move across the street. We shut down Wisconsin Avenue. We made as much noise as possible. And now we're here back again. This isn't going to end today. So make sure that you take action. If you go to www.amnestyusa.org/pussyriot, there's an action there that sends a message directly to Vladimir Putin that tells him to free Pussy Riot now. So make sure that you post that on Facebook, you tweet it out to your friends, you tell everybody. If you haven't already, there are also petitions back there in the tent. there are people kind of coming around with different flyers. Pick those up. Keep raising the call. This is just another moment in what's become a movement. And so again, I just want to really thank everybody for coming out here, for amplifying that call, for making sure that Maria, Nadezhda, and Ekaterina aren't forgotten, and that their cry for us to keep standing up in solidarity until everybody's human rights around the world are respected, that doesn't go unanswered. So thanks again for coming. So just hang tight for just a few more minutes. Like I said, grab some food. One thing that I want to remind people about, some of the bands that are here. Brenda has done something amazing at our last rally. One thing that they did was they committed to wearing their balaclavas for every single show until Pussy Riot is released. So that's huge. So they're kind of continuing to raise that call, and I'm asking you to stay committed. And so it's not just.
I'm gonna wear the balaclava, and I don't want to make the rest of my band. They don't want to, but I would love to wear it.
But there are a bunch of other bands coming up. So up next is going to be Mobius Strip. Stick around for them. After that, we have War on Women. And both of these are going to be amazing, amazing parts of tonight. So again, stick around. Keep the energy up. Make sure that the Russian embassy across the street hears us. Make sure that they hear us in Russia. Make sure that they hear us across the world. Thanks again.
Is called Step Down. It's about separation of church and state, which I think is pretty relevant to what's going on with Pussy Riot. So we write a lot of protest songs. They're not all specifically related to what's happening with Pussy Riot. Some of them are. We think that singing any song of protest is an act of solidarity now, given that Pussy Riot was put away, or maybe put away, for doing the same thing. What's that sound? So here's some more songs.
Thank you. Closer to you because you won't get closer to us. So that was three in a row. 67 in Battery Cage, which are about farmed animals. By Frontera.
The next song we're going to do is called Stand By. It's about taking action when you're supposed to. While he fixes that, it's about taking action when you're supposed to, not sitting around for the people to solve your problems or just wait for things to magically somehow get better. Hey, Mark. So, while they're troubleshooting that, we were talking earlier about some of our songs, and the last song that we're going to play today, which is a little bit away, is it's a song that we changed just a couple of words, and the song just turned into a song about Pussy Riot. And it was just kind of surprising to us how common government repression is, regardless of what field of activism you're in. And so it's just desperate governments trying to you know, squash movements by putting people in jail and make an example out of somebody. They can jail our activists, but they can't jail our movements. They can't jail all of us. And that's why we're here wearing balaclavas and dresses, which is not our usual attire, because anyone can pick up a balaclava or dress or guitar or sign or whatever and, you know, be part of the movement. They can't make us all go away.
Thank you.
Activists who've had their right to political speech squashed here in the United States. And we changed two words in the song, and it totally changed the meaning. So we'd like to ask you to join us in this one. There's a sing-along part. We're going to practice it for you real quick, and then we'll signal you when to sing along.
And hopefully you'll actually do it.
We're going to keep doing it until you join us, so unless you want to hear like a 15-minute long song, sing with us. All right, so the line to sing along to is Mark's line. Mark, what are your lines?
We won't shut up!
Right, easy.
What's the other one?
We won't back down!
All right, so it goes like this.
Wait, I forgot.
You'll never scare us into silence!
We won't shut up!
Despite your prisons and your violence!
We won't back down!
You got it? Alright, we're gonna come back to that in the middle of the song. We want you to sing with us.
Yeah. Thank you. make Russia hear us right now, so we're gonna do some chants. Make them free Pussy Riot. So, let's just start out. Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
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 Free expression,
not repression!
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 Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free expression!
No repression!
Free expression!
Not repression!
Free expression!
Not repression!
Free expression!
Not repression!
Come on, everybody, we need Russia to hear us! Come right across the street!
Right there!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free expression!
Free expression! It needs to be louder! It needs to be louder!
It needs to be louder, you guys! They're right across the street, they can't even hear us right now! Chant louder! We're live streaming too! Not family members of Pussy Riot can hear us, they want to hear a loud chant! Come on! Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
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 Free expression!
Not repression!
Free expression!
Not repression!
Free expression!
Not repression!
Free expression!
Not repression!
Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free, free!
Pussy Riot!
Free speech is not a crime!
Why are they still doing time?
Free expression!
No repression!
Free expression!
No repression!
Free expression!
No repression!
We won't be quiet!
Set free, Pussy Riot!
We won't be quiet!
Pussy Riot!
We won't be quiet!
Set free, Pussy Riot!
We won't be quiet!
Set free, Pussy Riot!
All right, guys, thank you so much!
Thank you so much!
Hey everyone, we're Warren Women, we're from Baltimore, and we're gonna play some songs in just a minute if you guys can bear with us. Thank you all so much for sticking around. Thank you to Amnesty International. Thank you to all the bands. Thank you to the food trucks. Hello? Thank you, food trucks. All right, in just a few minutes, we'll go on. Thanks so much. We're gonna try to beat any potential rain. I've been doing a lot of interviews and doing a lot of thinking about why this matters, and I can't think of a more stark contrast between the way that people like us are treated and people in Russia are treated. We're playing protest songs to a crowd for free in our country's capital. None of us are gonna go to jail. It's hot here. It's not even cold. I don't even need this decaf. It really, really highlights some of the, how unfair it is over there. And not just for artists, just for anyone to express dissent. It's punk rock, but we still want to be in tune. Sorry. If anyone feels like they can't make it through our entire set or if the weather cuts us off, we are playing Slutwalk DC tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. After some coffee, we're going to be playing Slutwalk DC 11:30 a.m. at Sylvan Theater right next to Washington Monument. Are you going to be there? a show. We're going to give them a show. We're War on Women. I can't hum along to that. appropriate, my necklace has two little handcuffs on it, and right now it's strangling me. The very first video off of our record, which is for sale at the Amnesty tent, premiered yesterday on thenation.com, which is pretty fucking cool for a political punk band, for their video to be featured on a political news source. That's kind of punk to me. So this is a song, you can find the video online, and you can find it on that record, right about now. So much. This is our last song. It's also on the record over there. We have free buttons, stickers, tampons, condoms, all over there for you. So please take what you need. Last song. Who cares? It's a squeal. You ready? Okay. Hey!
Thank you.
Thank you, Warren Women. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much, everyone, for coming. Don't forget, we have one more week. The sentencing is expected on August 17th. Be sure to go to amnestyusa.org. Look for to take action. You want to reach out. We want to make sure our voices are heard and these women are not silenced. Thank you so much. Free Pussy Riot!
You all know that as the trial closed, the women all made statements, so if you'd like to hear those, Amnesty will be linking to them shortly as soon as we put up videos for this event and photos, so if you want to hear what they had to say, I think it's a really great opportunity, and thank you all so much for coming.